you could do museum tickets too, where Kenny is today, and that is a fantastic display that they've been excited for so long.
Kenny, I mean, are you afraid yet? I'm hearing all that noise behind you.
Very cool stuff.
Yeah. Well, you know, it just kind of sounds like the newsroom does when there's free food.
I was going to say, it actually sounds like my stomach. Right.
Yeah, you're right. That's for sure.
So I'm used to the sound of that. You know, go figure. But what's really cool, learning a lot about different dinosaurs, not the North American dinosaurs, the one we find here. This was the whole thing about Ultimate Dinosaurs here at the Natural History Museum. That's actually Jim's stomach. He's kind of hungry. It's okay, Jim. We'll get you a donut here in a second. Okay, so Amanda, for those just joining us, we're looking at fossils and dinosaurs that were in Africa,
correct.
Madagascar,
South America, and Antarctica.
Okay, so these we're going to look at now, they were found in Africa.
Correct.
Talk about this guy, the Oranosaurus, is that correct?
Yeah, so Oranosaurus lived in northern Africa, and this was the big plant-eating dinosaur in that environment. So this is one of the duck-billed dinosaurs, which we do have in North America, but what's really interesting about this one is it has this big sail on its back, which
yeah,
we don't...
The big spines,
Big spines, yeah, that would have been a sail. We don't see any duck-billed dinosaurs in North America that have that unique sail.
Been argued by paleontologists what the whole principle was. Two schools of thought. One was fat storage.
Could have been fat storage. It could. This one probably had a sail though, so it was probably to help warm it up in the sun for thermoregulation. And it might have also been for defense or for display. I mean, when it turns to on its side, it looks bigger.
Okay, and then. Some people say when you're in television, you have a big ego, so you have a big head. That's funny. Look at this guy. Now, this guy really needed to become a television reporter because that's a big head. Look at that thing. That's huge. And this is the...
This is Carcharodontosaurus. Mm-hmm. So a lot of people think this looks like T-Rex, but, and it is similar, but the skulls are longer and thinner, and the teeth also are... thinner. So if you look at a T-Rex tooth, it's very round like a banana, and these ones are much more
knife-like. So these are thinner, knife-like slicers, boom, go to town. Man, yeah, that's pretty crazy. How big would this guy be? If the head's that big.
This one, unfortunately, we haven't found a lot of the skeleton, but based on the size of the skull, it would have been about the same size as T-Rex.
Wow. Okay, big guy. And speaking of big guys, this had to be... the top dog, right?
So this one actually is not the biggest.
Really?
So this one is called Suchomimus, and it is a Spinosaur, but Spinosaurus was the biggest meat-eating dinosaur in Africa, and it also would have had a bigger sail. That's what would have made this different than this one, and it was bigger.
So this is the big meat-eater.
This is the big meat-eater, but this one was eating largely fish. If you look at his hands, he has big claws for catching fish.
Really?
And then also he has a very crocodile-like skull with teeth that were adapted for eating fish.
So he hung out by the water a lot. That was really cool.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, you'd think this guy would eat some other, but if fish is the plentiful source, then there you go.
Exactly,
And then in here, Pride, so this is kind of like the evolution of the crocodile.
Crocodiles, yeah. So the exhibit has a lot of cast material, but it also has real fossil material.
And these are real fossils.
These are real fossils, and these are skulls that kind of highlight the diversity of crocodiles in Africa in the late Cretaceous.
Awesome. Okay. And let's talk about while we wrap up the extended hours.
Yeah. So over the holidays, we have extended hours. We're open later on Fridays and we open early on Sundays. And you can get more details on the website.
Sounds good. All right. See, learning a lot. Look
that's
at all the
so
dinosaurs
cool.
roaming the earth. How neat is that?
I love those
back
fossils.
Yeah, it's fascinating stuff.
Very
they're uncovering all of that.
Very much so.
New dinosaurs.
All right.